send into you to give you oxygen, hoping that you could breathe, having to take you into intensive care, staying there for as long as you had to, but you kept fighting. You never gave up, you never quit, you just kept fighting, and you said, I'm going to breathe, and you did.
I did not talk when I was first born, everybody knows that.
Actually, you did. I was there.
Okay.
It's actually before that. And you have been breathing ever since. And it occurred to Mom and I that what you have, what enabled you to fight through it back then, what enabled you to keep breathing, what enabled you to make it here today, is that you have superpowers. Now, we all know that you are a bit of a superhero fan. And it occurred to Mom and I, as we look at that, that there are superpowers in you. Now, we thought maybe your superpower was building Legos and Zords, but that wasn't good enough. And we could have called you Lego Man, but that would have been a good superhero title for you. And what really occurred to us, it's really not one superhero or superpower that has enabled you to get to this point, but it's a combination of superpowers. And those include influence from all your favorite superheroes, including
Iron Man. And the reason Daddy and I chose Iron Man, because we know how strong, how intelligent, and how humorous, and what an amazing gadget, creative person he is, how he figures things out like you do. By about 3 or 4 or 5 years old, I probably had 3,000 Legos in my basement. I secretly, during one morning, decided these Legos needed to be turned into the Lego store in Franklin Lakes, where I could get a coupon so you could go back and buy more Legos. I bagged them up. I took Sam over in the car. We had an enormous meltdown in the car because he said, I can build other things with these Legos. And after convincing me for about 20 minutes in the parking lot at the store, I turned around and went home. And
Sam, you took the car off by one of them.
Okay, Sam.
But what happened was when we came home, those Legos then, like Iron Man, got constructed into something completely different. The other reason Mitchell and I chose Iron Man was because of his sense of humor. Brittany and I were in the car, probably when he was about 4 or 5 years old, maybe 6. Mitchell was in Chicago doing some business at that point, and he was a little bit older. We'd been driving for a while, and I heard in the back seat of the car, when is Daddy coming home? And I said, we'll be home in a few days. Good, because I've had enough of the two of you. And that pretty much sums up my son. You just had enough of that.
Well, yeah,
you
know, that's where did I get my
So the next superhero that we figured was a part of you is Batman. Now, Batman is great with learning the clues, looking at the clues, and solving the crime. And you certainly know how to follow the clues. You know how to look at the clues and lead you something great, and that's what you're on the start of today, is finding the clues and seeing that's where it's going to take you. The other reason that we picked Batman is because you are, if nothing, great with the gadgets. You know how to use the gadgets, and you have your own utility belt that you are going to use to get through life. Now, if I'm reading it right, and today is a day for great gifts, you're going to see my friend Jimmy Marks out there, and he's going to have a Batman utility belt that we've been wanting ever since we were kids, and he's going to get it for you.
Oops.
Okay. So the next superhero, Mom.
Was Spider-Man. We chose Spider-Man because Sam has spider sense. He can see things other people can't see. I remember going into the doctor's office with Sam at a young age, and he said to the doctor, why did you move the clock? He remembered the clock had been in another location than it had been the last time he did it. He also has great sense of smell, touch, food. When I make chocolate chip cookies, he'll come up into the kitchen and he'll say, were these store-bought? And I'll say, no, they're homemade. All right, then I don't want any, because Mom, I don't want to hurt your feelings or anything, but they're not as good as what I can have. He always says, though, however, I don't want to hurt your feelings first, which always makes me feel a lot better.
Uh-oh.
superpower that I figure you have is from the Red Ranger, the Red Power Ranger. And the Red Ranger is Jason. And Jason's the team leader. This is another one that we think will be very helpful for you on the journey you're starting today. We expect you, and we think, Sam, that you're going to be the leader going through life. We want you to be the leader. We think you have what it takes to be the leader. And we look forward to seeing you be the Red Power Ranger for the rest of you, going through the rest of your life.
My next superhero was the Pink Ranger. I chose the Pink Ranger because she's one of our favorite Rangers, Samson and I. And I chose the Pink Ranger because most of you in the room know that I was diagnosed with breast cancer when I was pregnant with Sam. Sam saved my life, and the surgeon told me in the office after I got clean from the cancer that I would dance at Sam's Bar Mitzvah. And without Sam having been born, it would have not been such a happier, positive road. So he is my angel and a blessing from God. And because I love you so much, I want to thank you for saving my life.
Okay, Mom, you can do half dad, keep over on your butt.
So our last superhero, I'm not sure really is the classic superhero, but the last influence, Sam, is Luke Skywalker.
Oh.
Sorry, so we disappointed. And of course, the reason we picked Luke Skywalker is because Luke, I am your father. Now, this is important because, Sam, as people may or may not know, today you took on an incredibly difficult, unique, and important endeavor of reading the same Torah portion, your Haftorah portion, not only as your great-grandfather, Sam, who you're named after, but it's also the one that I read 42 years ago. And it was a great pride for us and Mom and I to see you take on the family legacy and do as well as you did. And what we learned today, what we saw today, that was the fruit of all the hard work, as the rabbi talked about, is that the force runs strong with this one. So we want to say, keep on fighting, Sam. Take all your superpowers and keep going. You're starting a great journey in life today. Remember that your superpowers will get you there. We'll always be there for you. And we are so proud of all the hard work and all the fighting that you have done to get to this day.
I'd like to say one last thing, too. Sam's middle name, Anthony, was the name of my granddaddy, my dad's